My inventing is a very purposeful process, bringing to bear my own skills and learning or bringing others with comparable skills to collaborate with and then solve the problem.
The Berkeley-Darfur stove was designed to address a need in Darfur. It was for a humanitarian crisis.
Civil war erupted in Darfur in 2003. 400,000 men had been killed.
Ashok's work already aligned with doing, you know, things in for developing countries. So he had a lot of expertise with how to execute technologies in places that are difficult to get technologies into.
And then out of this blue, I get this call from officer of USAID's Office of Foreign Disaster Assistance. And he said, the women are only given raw food by the UN agency and they don't get the fuel. So they must leave the safety of the camps, go out into the desert. And that's when they're attacked by the Janjaweed. He said, you have to try to do something about this. And I began to discover that the problem was real. 98% of the women were cooking on three rocks on which you place a round bottom pot and light a fire underneath. And I said, we should certainly be able to figure out how to make that much more efficient.
The Berkeley Darfur stove is a metal stove replacement for their traditional stove that lets people cook the same food, using the same pots and the same fuel that they've always used, but using about half as much fuel and cooking about twice as fast.
I would say that the Darfur stove is co-designed with large amount of input from Darfuri women cooks. The cost of the stove, including shipping, delivery, training, and handing it off to the women, training them, the whole thing, is about $20. And it saves the recipient $1,700 worth of fuel wood over his five-year life. Early in 2017, out of nowhere, I received this email which simply said, I grew up around the Berkeley Darfur stove. I am from Darfur. Can I come and see you? I couldn't believe what I was reading. I think if anybody even got out of the camps, that would be a phenomenal lifetime progress for that person.
I got the response immediately, instantly, that you don't normally expect to have such a thing, but I got it with that much excitement from him. And he just offered me an opportunity to go there and meet him at his office, which is kind of a pleasure for me.
So I said, is this indeed correct? Are you really saying you grew up around a Berkeley Darfur stove? Are you really from Darfur? And he says yes to everything. It was truly incredible.
No one from my community ever dreamed to come to the United States, let alone come and study in this institution. So that motivation really pushed me to do hard work to kind of overcome all these kind of obstacles.
It turns out that, my God, he's a master's student in architecture at UC Berkeley. And he had indeed grown up around the Berkeley Darfur stove.
The way it was built is very simple, and the simplicity of it translated into efficiency. And I thought, me myself, I could do something like that, but how could I do something like that living in that community? That's the spark that the stove, I think, gave it to me.
Ashok is the kind of person that people want to crowd around. If he's in a village, he'll be crowded by the women and children. If he's at an academic conference, academics will crowd around him. If he's in the classroom, his students will crowd around him. And that's because people respect and care about Ashok, because he respects and cares about people.
I was really impressed by the fact that a UC Berkeley professor was really interested in helping and genuinely helping people in developing countries. But it was really heartening to see someone who is so dedicated to this mission of making their lives better.
I love his personal character, the way he engaged with people, the way he talked to people, the way he inspired people.
The power of our creativity and knowledge base of science and technology, what we have at our fingertips, is truly unprecedented. But learning to pick up what is needed and apply it with perseverance and some amount of humbleness to make the world better is feasible.